haven't left home in a while. How is your team taking it? Because they probably want to be out there selling, managing, meeting. So have you been speaking to your customers as well, the businesses, restaurants? What has been the sentiment? I mean, it's a very situational question, so I'd love to hear what the market is saying and what you guys are thinking about the current scenario.
So see, to be honest, the current scenario is unprecedented. It's something that no one in their wildest dreams imagined would happen. In fact, we didn't. Until the first of May, we were in a complete growth-driven mindset. We had a clear target for the quarter that we were going to achieve and things like that. And I think by the 15th, we realized that this is how things are going to be. And the mindset shifted from growth to survival. Because what we've seen happen in other countries the last few months and what we expect to happen in India as well is that predominantly the markets that we work within, so the brick and mortar stores, or restaurants, cafes, retail stores, salons, these businesses are going to be impacted the most. Because with the lockdown, obviously, a lot of these businesses aren't even allowed to remain open. And for the mid-market or enterprise, this might be a revenue hit in terms of them not meeting targets and stuff like that. But for small businesses, this might be a matter of survival. A lot of these guys work on a monthly basis. A lot of them need to cover basic costs like rent, staff payments, stuff like that. A few of our clients, in fact, one or two have already gone under because they haven't been able to cope. So it's a very, very tough market. For us, we realized two things. Number one, we needed to kind of get ahead of the situation now and kind of start talking to customers from the get-go. So as a measure, around the 14th of March is when we kind of, number one, pushed our entire team to work from home, because we figured that this is what's going to happen. Number two, we sent out a newsletter and spoke to every client of ours, informing them that we'll be pausing their subscriptions from 16th of March onwards until further notice for all non-operational outlets, wherein they weren't actually running their business. So I think that really helped us because that was very good from a sentiment perspective. We understood this is things are going to be difficult for not only us, but our clients as well, and tried to get ahead of that situation. So it was, we did get a lot of brownie points for that. In terms of customer conversations, I think in a time like this, as I mentioned, the mindset is from growth to survival, right? So our core objective for this quarter is not to grow at X percent, but to ensure zero MRR loss. That means that we don't lose even one outlet on the platform, one way or the other. So what we've kind of done internally is that we tend to have a conversation with every single customer, however small or big they are, at least once in 2 weeks, just to kind of gauge in terms of how they are feeling, where they feel we can kind of help them in the situation, and what their outlook is towards the market. Simultaneously, we did, keeping in mind the situation and where we kind of saw things going, we decided to kind of take some action instead of just sitting and doing nothing. And I mean, it's time like this where, I mean, this the saying goes really well that you need to make lemonade out of lemons, right? And that's something that we did very, very quickly. We launched a platform called Save Local. So Save Local is an initiative by Hashtag Loyalty to help brick and mortar businesses and small and medium businesses basically kind of generate some sort of cash flow during these difficult times by selling gift cards to their customers.
And people have been buying to their favorite stores. How is that going?
Absolutely. So Save Local has been pretty good. So it was a decision we took on a Thursday, and it was live on Saturday night at 1 a.m. So within 72 hours, we took this from idea to a production release. I think it's been about 22 days, 25 days since we went live. We currently have about 225 brands on the platform, which in total have more than around 2,000 outlets. the good thing is that we've seen a lot of businesses, a lot of complementary businesses that we might have competed with, kind of come together with us on this. We've got a lot of new partners in place, stronger partners. Guys like I mentioned earlier, Quick Dry Cleaning and Garage Plug kind of came through to start off with as a partner, Save Local, to extend this offering to their clientele as well. At the same time, on a consumer front, we've seen some decent traction. We've sold, in the last 20 days, we sold about 5.8 lakhs worth of gift cards. It's not much, but it's a good start. As and when the lockdown extends, I think this is something that businesses see as a decent chunk of their revenue coming from. The key so far that we've noticed in terms of businesses that have been selling actively have been the personalization and the kind of communication they've been sending out. I think emotions play a big role here. I think it's very, very important for a business owner to understand the situation he is and kind of show where he is today and what he's going to kind of put out, use these funds for. And for customers, more importantly, to be more empathetic of the current situation and kind of use this as means to support their favorite businesses.
Hope you enjoyed my conversation with Krishi of Hashtag Loyalty. There are a lot more episodes coming out this week. Look for Stars and Startups on the podcast player of your choice or follow me right here on LinkedIn. Thanks for listening.